So we bring on Coach Breschi now, of course, and Coach, the ACC Coach of the Year, and you do this, of course, last year you were unbeaten at the time of the shutdown, but really in the last couple of seasons, you've propelled your program all the way back to the top of where it was a few years ago back in 2016. What would you say has changed in these last couple of years for you guys?
Well, I think we've, a couple things. One is the coaching staff. I love Coach Metz Bauer as our offensive coordinator the last 8 years for us. And Kevin Unterstein came on 3 years ago. Obviously, we had a shortened season last year. Coach Fox, who works with our face-off guys, has done a wonderful job. So I really credit certainly the coaching staff, number one. For the recruiting job that they've done and bringing in some terrific players. And then, the players have just been fantastic. Obviously, with a couple of fifth-year guys back, a couple of grad students as well, it's a veteran group. So I think you talk about that first midfield coming back. And, not a lot of people talk about it. But, with the shutdown last year, we had Roy Williams donated $600,000 to have all senior spring sport players for all the sports come back. And we have our entire first midfield back, Cam Macri, Tyler Simonetta, all came back because of that. So we probably wouldn't be in the position we are right now if it wasn't for Coach Williams' generosity to the program.
So you are saying without that, they probably would have gone on to do something different, some of those guys?
Yeah, maybe played elsewhere or just went into the professional world. So, I think from our perspective, it's, we're blessed to have them back. When a group like that, who has been on the same midfield for 5 years, they've played together. It's pretty powerful. They know each other really well. And that's why we got off to such a great start last year as legit seniors and now as fifth-year seniors. They're just playing at a different level.
Yeah, it feels like for you guys, continuity has been important in a year where there's in some places more than others, of course. You've had some of those grad transfers on the men's and the women's side. How much, I guess, has that helped you in having just that rapport with each other that you've been able to develop now?
Yeah, it's been fantastic. I think last year's shortened season with 7-8 games that we played, having Chris Gray for that shortened season get acclimated with the players, and then we had fall ball this past year in preparation for the 21 season. It was like night and day. The way he and he's a very humble and hungry player, and the way he makes everybody around him so much better. He's just done a wonderful job. But, once that fall or that shortened season was over, and then we get into this season, the offense has just taken off with his leadership.
Was there a chip on the shoulder there after? You guys were 7-0, I think it was. But you didn't play an ACC game, so there were some question marks there going into this year saying, hey, maybe the country thinks we have something to prove here. But was there any of that thought?
Yeah, absolutely. I think our guys wanted to prove something. And the gauntlet that is the ACC, obviously we didn't play just 4 games this year in an ACC tournament. We played 6 regular season games without a tournament. So with the COVID era, we wanted to make sure that we were able to get games in. So all the coaches agreed to take this approach. Every week was a huge challenge. But our guys definitely play with an edge, and some days were better than others, some games. But I think we played some complete games during that run.
Yeah, speaking most recently, your most recent run, you lost those games to Duke and OT, UVA by 2, and then you finished with wins over Syracuse, Notre Dame, and Duke. Was there something that flipped there? Was there a change, or just sort of the same steady feel that you've had? You just happened to win those games?
I think the Monday after the Virginia game, we kind of really broke things down. We'd been inconsistent at both ends. Duke, we felt like we didn't play particularly well offensively the entire game. And defensively, we struggled against UVA. And we just said, look, the potential in this room is real. If we can put it together at both ends and play a complete game, which I thought we did against Syracuse up in the Dome, and then we're pretty consistent in the final two as well. I said, the sky's the limit for this team. And we were able to get a share of the ACC championship along the way.
We know so much, of course, about Chris Gray. Will Bowen's had a great year. Nicky Solomon, some of those guys, you hear those names a lot. Who are some of the unsung heroes that you've seen stick out that we need to be talking about more in this tournament?
Yeah, I think you start with our goalie, Colin Krieg. He's a freshman. He's been just outstanding. The gauntlet of the ACC, he's been fantastic. His percentage over the last six, seven games is higher than his first six and seven games with probably tougher competition. So I think from that perspective, it's him. It's Cam Macri. It's Sean Morris at the defensive end, or two-headed monster at the faceoff X, and Andrew Tyre and Zach Tucci. But really the midfield, I think about the second midfield that has come along so well, and Henry Schertzinger and Alex Trippi, Connor McCarthy, Lance Tillman and Cole Herbert. We all talk about our first midfield, but it's those guys that have really made us tough to stop at times with the depth we have at the midfield.
I believe it's your first time back in the tournament since that 2016 year. You know, what is the message here for you guys? Do you have a feel that's similar to then, or how? I mean, what's the vibe like?
Well, those fifth-year guys actually were in the tournament in 2017. We lost to Albany in the first round. We won the ACC championship that year, and those guys were just determined, right? They came back for a reason. They came back to compete. Our first goal was to win the ACC championship, and next was to compete for a national championship, and we're in it. And everybody's 0-0. There's 16 teams left, and I think we have as good a shot as anyone.
As does the women's side for you at North Carolina. I mean, what's going on in Chapel Hill, Coach? I mean, two number one seeds, that doesn't happen a whole lot.
No, I know we're talking lacrosse here, but, you know, we had the selection show on Sunday, and 10 minutes before the selection show, right across the street from us, the field hockey team won the national championship against Michigan in overtime, which we could hear the roar. Many of our guys were there. They came running over. It was just really a special time. Our soccer programs are both in the Final Four right now as we speak, and women's tennis is the number one seed in their NCAA tournament. Men's tennis is the sixth seed in the men's side, and Jenny Levy is the one seed. And I'm telling you, they could beat us. They are so loaded from that. I'm not going to play her. I think she wanted to play us earlier in the season. I was like, no, Jenny, you know, let's hold off on that for now. Maybe next year when some of those girls graduate.
They have, I think, the super team is what you could call it this year. They're the team to beat, right? I mean, from your evaluation, too, apparently, on campus.
No doubt. And then the big thing that I tell our players is make sure you get to the first half of their games. Because the second half, it's, you know, they're already up 10 and the clock's running. So it's pretty powerful, but fun. I think it's great for the student-athletes, right? They look around, look to the right, look to the left. You have, you know, all the success from the different student athletes, and they're all cheering and supporting each other. So it's pretty impressive.
Well, you guys got Monmouth in the first round. Good luck in that game. You play the winner of Lehigh Rutgers. Coach, good luck this weekend. Congratulations on the one seed. And once again, what a great season you guys had.
Thank you so much. I appreciate you having me, and we look forward to the next chapter.
Absolutely.